everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Warism. This is a modded war survival server with my friends where we are playing on our own custom mod pack, and essentially, we're preparing for war and preparing for battle. Are there some slimes I hear? Do I hear some slimes? We're gonna be messing around with a ton of different mods today. I'm super excited. I'm just gonna have to smack them with my stick. All right, well anyway, oh, there's one little guy left. I'm sorry you had to witness that. If you were lighthearted, I should have done a trigger warning there. But anyway, guys, welcome back to Warism. Last episode was so much fun. I really enjoyed playing around with my friends, and we also got a chance to look at the new security craft mod, which was a lot of fun. It let us add in some few things. We didn't build too much in the last episode, but today we're gonna be getting a lot done. And that sort of started with what I did off camera here. I did a lot of work on the tunnels, and they might look a little different to you. And that is the fact that I went through and I finished the entire set of tunnels all by hand. I did the roofs, I did some of the walls, and they are completely done, at least for the sections that we have all the floors planned out to. So that's kind of cool. And this way, it even connects up over here to the hangar. I also did this area as well, so you can actually walk up to the hangar now when it's all completed. Look at this. This took me a couple hours, but it wasn't too bad, because with modded Minecraft, the resources are so easy to get, and also mining away all this stuff is very easy to get, and it looks really nice. I'm happy with it, and this exits right over to our hangar, where little zombies wait for us. Anyway, let's go ahead and test out this guy. This is a camera monitor, so it's going to connect up to a security camera that we have placed somewhere around the tunnels. Did you guys see it? I walked past it when I was running around the tunnels. I don't know if anybody saw it, but we can go ahead and select the camera to view. We can click on camera number one, and oh gosh. Oh man, this is embarrassing. What is going on? What is going on? I guess you can't have cameras placed next to walls. So essentially, what happens when you, here's our security camera, it's this little guy up here. But, so we have a little security camera there, and we have it bound up to a camera monitor. And what happens when you go to view it, your little guy actually gets teleported from wherever he is. He gets teleported into the security camera, and he's pretty much frozen. I guess he's invincible too, but I started taking damage there. That was weird. All right, let's try this. We will go to camera number two. No, we're still taking damage. That is so obnoxious. Okay, let's go ahead. We'll put the security camera in a different spot. Maybe not on top of the walls, but we'll just put him right here. So that way he's watching down the whole aisle. And here's the cool thing about the camera monitors. So no matter where you are, you can go ahead. Oh, we haven't bound our camera up. So the first thing you have to do is you have to take the camera monitor and you gotta bind it onto the security camera. Now the difficulty is going to be actually finding a way to hide the security cameras. Because if the security cameras are here, as the enemy team's walking by, the enemy team could just easily, you know, pop it off the wall. And then we wouldn't be able to connect to it. But let's go ahead, we'll select the view. And now we can sort of see what we're looking at. And you can even move around. This is pretty cool. This is pretty cool. I like how it's nice and slow and automated. It's like we're actually in a security camera. That's pretty cool. It also has a zoom in and a zoom out feature. That's pretty funny, in case you really wanted to see the tunnels there. And then it even has a night vision that you can go ahead and toggle. But I think that's used up by one of the map controls. Anyway, here is the coolest part. We can actually push the R key, and the R key will allow us to toggle a redstone signal. So here's my idea about how we can actually use the security cameras. We can actually hook them up to some sort of redstone trap lying around our base. And that way, whenever we see the enemy team passing by on our security cameras, we could be like, okay, the enemy team, they're in hall number three. They're in the long hall right here. Boom. We can use the security cameras to actually activate a redstone trap that could release, you know, zombies from the ceiling, or it could do all sorts of things. Really, it's just up to our imagination, but that would be such a nice and fun idea. Definitely something we should look into. I thought it would be fun today. We've been working on this tunnel for quite some time, but I think it would be a lot of fun to create a protective doomsday vault just in case matters go to worse, because chances are some sort of nuke or, you know, explosive device or something like that is going to go off and there are going to be a lot of deaths. We don't have any nukes in the mod yet or anything like that, but we are planning on adding ICBM and some sort of explosive rockets and missiles. So I think it would just be a good idea, you know, in case the battle isn't going the correct way, I need some safe space to go that can be my own. It can be nice and hidden. I believe we can build it out of these reinforced blocks. Where was my reinforced thing? I had a reinforced thing on it. Anyway, you can get a block reinforcer, and essentially, you can make any block, like, super, super powerful, and you're just not able to break it. You saw him last episode in the cage trap when we actually trapped Nick, but it allows me to create some sort of vault or area that I can get into with security craft, and I can keep protected from all the enemies. And essentially it'll just be a last case, you know, everything's going wrong. I'm gonna connect it up to the tunnels here and it should be a pretty good build. Now, before we move on to making some sort of vault, I think it would be best if we went ahead and I wanted to add one more thing to the tunnels here. I believe it was in this section right here. So I think it would be such a fun idea if instead of, so here's how the tunnels work. Up here we have it leading up to the hangar. And then this tunnel does a little circle around to this point right here. You can see it's a little circle. And that's it. So it's a circle, and then it leads in this direction, and that's towards our home base. So I think it would be fun and also extremely confusing to anybody who's not quite familiar with the tunnels if we went ahead and we just added in a massive wall that's going to be completely fake. So it's not going to be, you know, too difficult. Nobody's going to get that fooled by it, but it's just going to add that extra level of confusion that we want. So let me go ahead. Oh my gosh, it keeps sucking up the texture from the floor. The way these ghost blocks work is you place them down and it sucks up the texture from any blocks around it. So all these little blocks around it are, it's sucking up the texture from the wrong block. But there we go. So now we have a wall. It looks like a real wall, but you can just walk right through it. Awesome. And we can go ahead and add this in on this side and check this out. It looks like a totally normal wall. Heck, we can even add in a little light to it. Oh my goodness, no way anybody can find that out. So unless you are familiar with the tunnels and you know that this is indeed a secret wall right here, you might just be running around in circles forever. And now there's one other thing that one of you guys actually mentioned in the comments, which is such a nice idea, and that is the fact that all these little light bulbs all around the place, they look kind of ugly. And a cool way you can actually go about completely hiding the light is we could just replace one of these blocks, so we'll do this guy right here. We can replace it with a carpenter's block, and then we can go ahead and give it the exact same texture that it had, so there we go. It looks a little funky. Okay, there we go. I replaced it with the top guy. The texture's connected up this time and it looks fine, but there is a carpenter's block right there. And what you can do is you can actually add glowstone to a carpenter's block. And just like that, you have light. That is so amazing. That is such a nice idea. So now we can light up the tunnels all over the place. Like, we could go ahead, add in a little carpenter's block here, and go ahead, add some light to it. There we go. So I've been doing some thinking about where I want to place this vault. Check this out. That was the ghost door that we just added. It is so sneaky. People are gonna get lost in these tunnels for hours, and we haven't even begun. Oh, buddy, get out of here. Get out of here. I got a flamethrower. You got a little bow. You're not winning this battle. Anyway, remember this? This was the secret door that you have to push to actually enter. So if we go down here, you can see this is the secret button on the wall right here. You push the button, you run in this direction, and we hooked up the redstone so that way it opens up just as you walk in to a zombie attack. Get out of here, zombie. You're not even spooking me. Did he just drop a mushroom? Why was he here holding a mushroom? But anyway, once we get in, we're inside now. This is the secret area And there obviously is one-way glass right here, and there's one-way glass over there, which allows us to see all the way through if anybody's roaming our tunnels. But what if I told you guys there was a third layer of one-way glass? So yeah, allow me to quickly show you guys this little extra expansion that I just added. So there's one-way glass right here, and that actually allows you to see through three one-way glass walls. That is ridiculous. So even if the enemy team manages to break in here and they're like, haha, I found a secret area, I can see through double one-way glass, I could be back here spying on them from triple one-way glass. That is pretty ridiculous. And then if we come around the back here, I even went ahead and connected it up to this tunnel. This is one of the other tunnels here. I'll mine through it real quick to show you what I'm talking about. So if we go through here, this is this side of the tunnel, and this connects up all the way over here. So this is just another way for me to actually see through it. So this is actually one-way glass right there, and then there's the first one-way glass. And so if you're over here, you could have three people, you know, spying on you at once. And that's just kind of spooky to think about that. But yeah, anyway, so the vault, we are going to be expanding over into this part of the tunnel. Over here, currently, we don't have anything. It's just a pointless circle that doesn't connect to anything. So we're gonna change that, and instead, right here, we're gonna connect it up to some sort of vault. I've already checked where this location is on the map, and it seems like we're by this nice little forest area, and this is actually right next to the hangar. So this is where we're planning on building the vault right here, and then if we walk over to this side, this is where the hangar is going to be, and the hangar is down over here. That's where we're going to be storing all of our airplanes and stuff like that. So it's a little bit close to the hangar, which we might want to fix and maybe bring it over to the side this way a little bit more, because we don't have much going on in that direction. But yeah, super excited to start this thing. So allow me to clear out a big area and reinforce all the walls, and then we should have a nice, you know, template and place where we can actually start building the vault. What is going on right now? Oh my goodness. This little guy right here. He just stole my pickaxe. I think he's a hungry zombie. Okay, I'm gonna let him out. And watch how fast he moves. I'm a little bit scared. Oh boy! Oh boy! What's he doing? What's he doing? Buddy? Hello? Why? He is so fast! You can't even hit him! What? What is going on? What is going on? Why are you what in the world? Where did he go? I hear him. This is terrifying. This is absolutely terrifying. He's pulling everything out of my inventory. Give me this golden bag back. Okay, I got it. Don't hit me. Don't touch me. He's a hungry zombie. Dude, if there was only a way where I could, like, capture him and I could release him on the enemy team. Like, this is ridiculous. What is even happening? Look how freaking fast he is. Dude, that is so terrifying. All right, go back down. Go back down to where you came from, buddy. Go back down to where you came from. All right, he's down there. Oh, he met some of his friends too. All right, guys, so I've been mining for quite some time now, and this is what we're sort of left with. Unfortunately, we started sort of going into a ravine here, and there's so many mobs down here. I cleared most of them out with my AK, but just like the amount of zombies and flaming zombies, is that the devil? What is even going on right now? Oh, he actually dropped a carrot. But anyway, I've been doing a whole lot of work, and I sort of outlined the outline of the bunker that we're going to be building. I did that with this stone here, so you can see it sort of goes in a half circle. I was thinking, you know, we have a stupid amount of gunpowder and a stupid amount of guns. Why don't we use some explosives to assist us with some of the mining? Maybe we can blow up some of this stone instead of simply mining it out. I think that would work a little bit better. So we're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna craft myself, I'm gonna craft myself another minigun with the explosive ammo. I was looking at some of the grenades. We might wanna think about using some grenades, but we can use this minigun and it has explosive ammo. Alright, so I found the minigun that we used previously, and oh my gosh, I forgot how sweet I look in this thing. I'm also wearing my my goofy little scuba helmet for some reason. I'm not sure why. I don't even think it gives me any protection. No, it's a gas mask. That's right, I don't know. I think it looks cool. It looks so sick, and it might just protect you from gases. You're supposed to use it as a scuba mask, but hey, we're using it as, we're looking like an astronaut. Anyway, fast forward quite a while, and we have some more minigun ammo. Now, the minigun isn't too expensive to make, neither is the normal minigun ammo, but this explosive ammo, one little packet of it, which is 500 shots, that costs 256 gunpowder. That's like 4 stacks of gunpowder. That is absolutely ridiculous. What is that spider? Do you see it over there? That's a funky looking spider. Get out of here, you little goblin spider. All right, let's go to town on some of this stone. Should we start with that creeper? Oh boy, I'm excited. Look at that. Look how sweet I look. Goodbye, Mr. Creeper. Oh boy. Oh no, that's right. I totally forgot about that. This minigun doesn't mine stone. It only mines dirt and gravel, right? Yep, it just mines dirt and gravel. Wow, that is so lame. I guess it also mines zombies, but... Alright, so I'm not too sure if this is the most efficient way to mine, but we're definitely going to be trying it out with our little AT-4, which is a pretty handy-dandy rocket launcher. I believe we have enough gunpowder. We do have the required ammunition. We're going to see how effective a rocket launcher is, and if it's not quite effective enough, well, we might just have to move up to a tank. I'm thinking I'm at that point to where a tank could be necessary in this situation. You know, we could just perch the tank up on this little walkway over there and then just go to town firing. But anyway, let's test it out. Whoa! Did I shoot so far? I shot so hard there that the rocket launcher flew out of my hand. All right, come on. Oh my goodness, look at that. I'm literally throwing the rocket launcher out once I shoot it. Why is that happening? Is that because it's so powerful? All right, buddy, you gotta stop shooting me. You gotta stop shooting me. But it looks like, am I even damaging the stone? Where's my rocket launcher going? I'm not dealing like, I'm literally breaking 3 blocks. Wow, that's sad. That is really sad. Is that all of our ammo? All right, well, that thing's stupid. Doesn't really do much damage. Let's try some grenades. All right, and so here comes the fun part. It's like throwing little bouncy balls in there. Oh my goodness. Oh, there were so many mobs. There's a little bouncy ball near you, buddy. Better watch out. Oh, that didn't quite hit you directly on impact. Oh, that one got you. All right, so we'll just sprinkle these all around the... Ooh, that was a good one. That was a real good one. All right, we're back at it again. This time we have a grenade launcher. Oh boy, look at this guy. So hopefully this one does a little more damage. I got the impact damage grenades. All right, line up. We need some mobs here. Need some mobs to line up. Here's a little glow-in-the-dark mob. And... Oh my goodness. That was dirty. That actually did quite a bit of damage. Yeah, look at that. There we go. All right, so I have done quite a bit of progress on our vault, and we've added a lot of new things to the tunnels. It's been a lot of fun. I actually got Nick and Caleb on the server. We got working. We finished a bunch of stuff, so I mainly worked on outlining my vault and getting that prepared, and then Caleb went ahead and worked on a project where he actually built a very nice entrance and exit to the tunnels. Anyway, I said having an entrance and exit easily accessible to the tunnels was pretty much on the top priority, and that's exactly what Caleb did over here. So you don't really notice it, but this wall right here is actually a ghost block. You can walk right through it, And we haven't quite finished the roof for this area, but I went ahead and did these tunnels. And then Caleb did this drop. And this is the coolest thing ever. I am so happy with what he did here. Check this out. So this used to be pretty much all ground. So you see how it's a little bit rainy outside, but you see how it's shallow right here. And then it's sort of shallow over here. This whole area used to be shallow like this. And then he took a pickaxe and he sort of mined out this giant area and he replaced it with a coral reef. So this is a man-made coral reef. I'm so happy with how this looks. And then from the inside, so as you're going down the drop, you sort of get this cool coral reef experience. I don't know, it was just a great addition and I'm really happy with how this thing turned out. That's like such a cool idea. I think it was a pretty difficult build. However, he did use the gas mask, so I guess it wasn't too bad. Anyway, this is a pretty cool expansion. I'm really happy. And now, this means whenever we're up here doing stuff, so we got the chicken farm up here, and you know, some cows and some chests, and whenever we're growing crops, and we're out exploring, well, it'll be very easy to just enter it. And we replaced all these with some ghost blocks, so you just slide right through, and then you're down in the drop. That is so sweet. And then these tunnels just basically connect up, and you're good to go out in the tunnel world. This bat's excited. Man, that is so cool. So here's another project idea that we were working on, and it has to deal with these carpenter's blocks, and specifically the garage door. Now, I didn't even know this was a block in the mod, but there are these pretty cool garage doors that you can hang from the top of any block, and they'll go all the way down, and it sort of looks like a garage door. And then if you go ahead and right-click it, it'll open up, and then you can right-click it again, and it'll close it. So that is such a cool feature, and I was trying to think of some cool things we could do with this. And the first idea that popped into my mind were some secret pressure plates. Now, the cool thing about this is these things actually respond to redstone. So if we go ahead and put some secret pressure plates down here, now whenever we walk on the secret pressure plates, it'll open them up and it'll close them. So look at that. That is like an automatic door that opens up whenever you get near it. I also put some pressure plates on the other side, so that way it works from both sides, and it's a completely automatic door. Like, that is such a cool idea. But also, I was thinking some more things we could do with this, and you can actually go ahead and right-click it with a hammer, and it will behave like an iron door. So now you can't actually right-click it with your hand. It's only going to open up if you give it a redstone signal, and that's what we can do with these pressure plates down here. So this is a really cool feature that I've been thinking about, and it just has to deal with putting some garage doors every so often. And essentially what that's going to do is, say we're in a gunfight, you know, say there's like three bad guys down here and I'm running in this direction. What I'm going to do is I'm going to enter through here and boom, I can go left, right. They can't see me through this garage door. Now at the moment they can, because we have it, the cool thing about these carpenter's blocks is you can give it any texture you want. So we were thinking about, you know, giving it the iron bar texture, makes it sort of look like a gate that was down. We could give it stone texture. You can give it any texture you want, but we can make it to where if you're running away from someone, you can pass through a garage door and then you can go left, right, middle, down, enter a secret passage. They won't be able to see you, and they also won't be able to shoot you. That's sort of the other feature I was thinking about. So, you know, if we're getting shot at and we're running away, we can run through a garage door real quick. It'll close behind us. And then if the enemy tries to shoot us, they won't have any luck. So it's kind of just a nice little security feature. And we could sort of just sprinkle them all throughout the place. Like we could put one right here. Anytime we have like a super long tunnel, because if an enemy team comes in here and starts shooting at us, you know, we're gonna kind of be screwed because we won't be able to get through the exit. Or is that even the exit? Where's the exit at? It's right here. We won't be able to get through the exit. Jeez, I'm already getting lost in these tunnels. And we haven't even begun to add, like, a whole lot of confusing bits to them yet. But I thought it was just a cool idea to sprinkle them around every so often. Anyway, that was just another thought that we had to add some more security and stuff like that. It's so much fun working with, you know, crazy security mods. And what we can do is we can have a lockdown mode where it's going to send like a redstone signal out to all the gates and they'll be like permanently locked. I think that'd be pretty cool. So then you can't actually, you know, open them up. Like, they'll just be permanently locked down. Might be a cool feature. Anyway, this is what Nick has been working on. This was Nick's project. He pretty much mined out a big area. Oh gosh, we got a slime chunk in here, don't we? But he mined out a big area over here, and this is going to be where the firing range is going. And then he also went ahead and started construction over here on sort of an armory. So this little room is going to be the armory. He doesn't know how to decorate it yet. We were still thinking about that. We were thinking about adding in possibly Bibliocraft or some other mods like that, just because at the moment we don't have a whole lot of decoration or storage or display cases or anything like that. So we're thinking about Bibliocraft, but if you guys know any other mods that are sort of give us display cases and stuff like that that aren't Bibliocraft, that'd be nice, because I like Bibliocraft. It's a fun mod. However, I just think it would be better to switch it up a little bit. We should also add a little line of garage doors right here. That would be a cool addition. Anyway, this is going to be the armory where we keep all of our guns. It'd be very nice to have, you know, a high level of security, because this is where this is going to be pretty important to protect and make sure enemies don't get in. So we added in a little bit of a garage door right here to just somewhat keep enemies out. All right, so this is where it starts getting kind of cool. So these tunnels, this tunnel right here, connects it up so that way our tunnel is finally a giant circle. So we can see we can go over here, and this is where the vault is going to be in that direction. And then it connects up to the tunnels, and now we have a giant circle of tunnels, which is really exciting because these tunnels are gonna start getting confusing. So this is a mini circle right here, then you gotta go through this wall. Oh man, this is like a glass wall, this is another glass wall. There are so many secrets already, and we haven't even like finished yet. We still got so many things to add. This isn't even the correct, this is the exit. I'm already lost. And then we can go down here. This is, this over here is another secret entrance actually. I think so. Yeah, if we dig through here, check this out. Boom, another secret tunnel entrance over there. And then we can go down here. We just added in this. This connects up to the hub, that little guy. And then we're back at the armory. So it's like a giant circle, which is really cool. And then we can just sort of stem out from this giant circle that we've added. Anyway, the armory, we made it connect up to the vault entrance, which is going to be right over here. So boom, we got ourselves the vault entrance. Pretty awesome, pretty cool stuff. So here is the vault. Now, unfortunately, I've spent so much time on this vault, I didn't have any time to decorate it, but the cool thing is, we are finally done with completing the vault. It's finally done, finally here, this is it. So, this thing took me ages to complete, simply because all of this stone right here is reinforced stone. And reinforced stone is stronger than, it's stronger than obsidian, stronger than everything. Essentially, nobody is going to be able to get inside of this room, other than zombies that spawn. But nobody's going to be able to get in. It's sort of our own private space, which is kind of nice. And then we can decorate it, make it look all fancy, you know, add a bunch of cool things. It's just going to be our doomsday bunker. You know, if the battle isn't going the right way, we can always just come right in here. And matter of fact, we don't even have to have sort of an entrance where we can risk other people getting in. I'll make it look like there's an entrance, but I think it would be even be cooler. Aren't there teleporters in this mod? I think in mekanism. Oh yeah, here we go, teleporter frame. So they did add teleporters into the mod. And look at this, so we can pretty much build a teleporter. So that way the only way in here is going to be to teleport in here. And that'll be a pretty cool twist to it. And then we can make it look like there's an entrance over here, but you won't actually be able to enter. So it'll just be like a little fake entrance. And then we can make a real teleporter in here. Oh, it's gonna be so nice. That's another project for another time. Anyway, that's about all the time I have for in today's episode. Hopefully you all have enjoyed. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next episode of Minecraft Warism. Adios.